Good evening. It's Monday the 27th of April and it's about 6:30 in the evening. Not the usual time for me to be doing these recordings, but it's a beautiful time of the day. Remember in Genesis it was the time of day when the Lord walked with Adam and Eve in the cool of the garden after the heat of the day. This evening, I would like us maybe just before we enter into that short period of prayer, just to focus not so much on the problem of the coronavirus that's troubling us all at this moment and that we want to end as soon as possible, but to focus rather again and again on the Lord. Sometimes we're tempted to treat our God as though he was some sort of extra public service who we call on when we have particular problems that need attention. And then we pray and we plead. And then as soon as the problem either ends or eases, we ease off our prayer until the next problem comes. We only recently were getting fed up with Brexit, and now we have this. And what comes after this? What's our next problem, whether it be as a family, an individual, or a nation, or the church? But our relationship with our Lord has to be more than that. Many of you already may have been distressed because your prayers haven't been answered as you'd like them to be. But as we enter into prayer, we're invited to trust more deeply in the Lord. He knows our problems better than we know them ourselves. He knows us. He knows what is good for us. So it's up to us to trust in him and just to learn to perhaps relax into his presence, like a child who is calmer because a loving parent has come to them or is still there. They haven't been abandoned or forgotten. God is not indifferent to the difficulties. Again and again for myself, whenever I'm faced with what appear to be overwhelming difficulties or hardships, I like to quickly think of what God has done for us. And that we're talking not just about problems solved in this life, but we're talking about ultimately the joys of the life to come. So on this beautiful evening, we'll spend some time just knowing that God is there for us. Jesus is risen. These are the days of new life. These are the days of the resurrection. And it's real for all of us, even for those who have no faith, even for those who have suffered terribly. God comes with the fullness of his love. What we have to go through will last a time, but God's love will last for eternity. God bless you all.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for those who have lost their lives recently. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them, may they rest in peace.